Hey programmers, today we start on recipes, which are a completely new idea in grandMA3. Since they're new, it does mean that there might be changes to them as the software progresses, so definitely watch your release notes. And for today, to better follow along, make sure that you've already seen my videos on presets and MAtricks. In my last video, we looked at using recipes with magic presets so that we can make them referenceable, but we didn't really dig into them much more than that. So what the heck is a recipe? I like to think of them as an additional reference layer that I can store within a preset or a queue. A recipe consists of what MA refers to as ingredients with instructions that can be cooked. The ingredients show up on an editable recipe line that can include a group selection, a preset to point to, and any MAtricks you want applied, but you don't necessarily need to include all of these items, and you can have multiple lines of recipes. The idea is that you could change these ingredients at any time and quickly update any presets or cues that use the recipe. You can also use recipes to create preset templates for any preset and a matrix combinations that you want to be able to quickly apply to different selections of fixtures. Recipes can be created within the programmer, within a preset, and within a queue. You'll be able to tell that there's a recipe in a preset or queue because it will have this little pot icon. There is no recipe pool. You could store a recipe as a preset in any of your preset pools, or, if you like, you could choose to dedicate one of your all pools to just recipes. Ultimately, the organization is up to you. Today, I want to begin with using recipes in presets because I think it's the most intuitive place to start. In the next video, we'll look at using recipes within the programmer and in sequences. I said earlier that I tend to think of recipes as a reference layer, the same way that a preset is a reference. So to me, a recipe within a preset is a lot like an embedded preset. So let's build one. A recipe can be added to an existing preset, or like what we're gonna do is add a recipe to an empty preset object. In this version of software, a recipe and a preset cannot reference itself in the recipe. There's positives and negatives to this. The positive is that you could get the most flexibility if you start with an empty preset, and you could create a bunch of different recipes that could apply different ingredients and instructions to a single preset, but the negative does seem to be that you end up with a lot of additional presets, so you're gonna have to make organization a priority. I'm swiping on an empty preset tile and going into Edit Options. Right away, you can choose to label your preset if you know what you're going to be using it for. Like maybe it's a verse or a chorus look, or a special for a performer. If you don't label it, the console will do its best to create a label based on your ingredients. This section in the lower half is where we add our ingredients and the instructions that will ultimately be cooked into creating our look. Let's say I want this recipe to be for my spot group, so I'll pick that in the group dropdown. And by the way, with each of these columns, if you don't want to use the dropdown, you can also use the assign keyword, pick your object, and drop it in the cell. In the preset column, I'm going to pick a color preset from my pool. If you're wondering if you can only store color presets in preset recipes in the color pool or the all pools, don't worry. Recipes do not care about any sort of input filters that the pools themselves have. These recipe lines are their own entities, and you're really just pointing to these other preset items. If you're using recipes in conjunction with phaser presets, and you've already dedicated a specific pool to phasers, maybe you add those recipes into that pool. So ultimately, store them wherever it makes the most sense to you. The rest of these options on the right are all options from our MAtricks, and they work just like they do in the MAtricks window. You can also change what you see on the line by using these toggles at the top, like if you wanted to invert or apply MAtricks on the Y or Z axis instead of just the X axis. You can manually input data here, like maybe a delay time of 0 through 1, add a wing or block if you like. Or, if you already have an MAtricks configured to your liking in the MAtricks pool, you can select it here in the MAtricks column, and all of that pool item settings will show up here on the line. You can tell that it came from your pool item because it will have these brackets around them. Alright, so I've got a basic recipe here with this line. You could add a new line below and do the same thing with maybe a different group of lights, or I could use the same lights and put them into another preset. It's all up to you. And while I'm thinking of it, you'll notice that there isn't yet a button on screen to delete a line, so if you do need to do that, hit the delete key and then touch the line. Okay, the next obvious question is, do we need to cook this? The answer is no, at least not right now. When you first create a recipe in your preset and add ingredients to your lines, the console will do the initial cooking automatically. So we can close this window. Then I'll click this recipe preset once to select the group used in the recipe, bring those lights to full, and then touch the recipe again to apply the look. Looks right, so let's also store it into a queue and trigger it. Then I'll clear out, leaving everything in playback. Now, if we go into this recipe and change the color preset that our recipe points to, you can see that the queue is already updated and we didn't even need to cook. I also don't have to cook if I go in and change any of these MAtrix options. But if I was referencing an MAtrix from my pool and I made a change to that pool item, I would need to cook. And I could do that from the edit options here, or I can put cook on the command line and touch the preset. If you're working with console hardware, the shortcut for cook is to hold down MA and press update. This preset we just created is selective to the group that I stored in the recipe. And I could go back in and change the group that I want this recipe to use. But if you're ultimately going to be storing these recipe presets into queues, I would very much advise against that. Look what the lights are doing in the fixture sheet. I can see a preset reference for this recipe preset on my color, which makes me happy. But check this out. I'm going to change this recipe's group ingredient from the spots to the auras, and the console auto-cooks it for me. My queue still looks the same, but if we look back in the fixture sheet, we see that the spots lost their preset reference and the color values are hard values, which are my enemy. That recipe preset will certainly work for the auras now, but any queue that used the original recipe is kind of screwed. Could this functionality expand and change in the future? Sure, maybe. There is a way in the current release to use recipes and change our group ingredients and queues, and we'll talk about that in the next video. For now, here's an example of a different way to use recipes and presets. I'm going to go into Edit Options on another empty preset, and this time I'm going to skip the group column. I'll add a couple of presets and some MAtrix pool objects that I created. What I'm essentially making here is a template preset. I'll be able to make a fixture selection of any group of lights that understands the presets I stored in the recipe and apply the recipe. This could be great for things you find yourself creating a lot, like getting some quick fly-ins or fly-outs with various MAtrix or fan timing already applied. Do remember to think of these no-group recipes as templates. What I'm storing in my queues is not a reference to this recipe preset, but rather a reference to the preset ingredients in the recipe. So in the fixture sheet, I see that my position is coming from the roof floor preset and my dimmer from the closed preset. The references are to my ingredients, not to the recipe preset itself. If it's confusing at all, just remember to watch your fixture sheet. Pretty much all of life's programming questions are answered within the fixture sheet. Let's talk real quick about cooking with these recipe presets. I already mentioned that when you're first creating the recipe in your preset, that the console will automatically cook the lines for you. In fact, you might see a quick little progress bar appear, which I'm guessing is a good indication that the console is cooking your ingredients. So when do you need to manually cook a preset? The answer is, it depends. Earlier in this video, we changed a color preset in a recipe and we didn't need to cook it for the queue with the recipe preset to be updated. But we also saw in the magic preset video that if I changed a magic preset that was used in a recipe and then used in a queue, I did have to recook the recipe preset to update the queue. It's something we're gonna have to play with to really figure out. Like I said, this is brand new functionality, so I feel pretty confident that it's gonna continue to evolve. In the next video, let's look at recipes within the programmer and in our sequences. See you then.